Prediction, prediction, prediction. Usap-usapan Manny Pacquiao for president in 2022. Prediction, prediction, prediction. Usap-usapan Manny Pacquiao for president in 2022. Prediction, prediction, prediction. Usap-usapan Manny Pacquiao for president in 2022. Prediction, prediction, prediction. Usap-usapan Manny Pacquiao for president in 2022. Hello, mga sangkayan, and welcome to my YouTube channel that spells the difference. Please like and subscribe and hit the bell for future uploads. Hello, mga sangkayan, and welcome to my YouTube channel that spells the difference. Please like and subscribe and hit the bell for future uploads. Hello, mga sangkayan, and welcome to my YouTube channel that spells the difference. Please like and subscribe and hit the bell for future uploads. Halina't samahan ninyo ako at ating pag-usapan ang hula na si Manny Pacquiao ang susunod na presidente ng Pilipinas. There is a standing rumor that Senator Manny Pacquiao is contemplating to run as president in 2022. In fact, there are a lot of people pushing him to consider running for president, some even predicting that Pacquiao will be the next president. Ano ang masasabi ng ating netizens tungkol sa usaping ito? Walang duda na si Manny Pacquiao ang isa sa pinakamagaling na boksingero sa kalaysayan ng mundo at ang kaisa-isang may hawak ng 8 kampyonato sa 8 magkakaibang na timbang o dibisyon ng boxing. Kung tapang at galing ang pag-uusapan at disiplina bilang isang atleta o boksingero, ibang level ay pinakita at pinamalas ng isang Manny Pacquiao. Ironically, sometimes boxing and politics converge like in the case of Manny Pacquiao. I personally consider that both boxing and politics are blood sports and maintain my position that sometimes politics is bloodier and dirtier than boxing. Pacquiao is no stranger in politics, for he is now seasoned politician. Politics is a different cup of tea, so different from the boxing sports that gives him prestige and honor. What you consider friends and allies today will be worse enemies in the future. In boxing, you can see and predict where the punches of your opponents will be coming from. And when hit by a low blow, the referee will stop the fight momentarily to give you time and space to recover. There is no referee in politics. Your opponents will try every dirty tricks and tactics and will continually hit you with low blows until you hit the canvas and stand no more. To aspire the highest positions of the land and serve the people well is an honorable and worthy ambition. However, you need to pay the price. Being the president is tantamount to laying down your life for the sake of the people and the country you are serving. The country has 16 presidents so far, but none of them give the life every Filipino dream of. Corruption both in the executive, judiciary, and legislative department are rampant. This is the call of the president as the chief executive of the government. This is what President Duterte is doing right now. I hope that he will succeed in removing corrupt government officials before his term expires. People wanted to see behind bars the mafia or syndicate at PhilHealth. If the president can't stop corruption in his administration, then he failed our trust and confidence when we elected him as president of the land. Take for example the massive and rampant corruption in PhilHealth. All PhilHealth high-ranking officials must be put in preventive suspension primarily for not policing their ranks and for taking for granted the huge amount of money syndicated from the agency. Manny Pacquiao should not consider running for the presidency because someone pushes him to do so or because of his personal ambition. Legendary boxing promoter Bob Arum repeatedly made public prediction that after Manny Pacquiao retired from boxing, he will become the next president of the Philippines. Freddie Roach, on the other hand, made pronouncement that after two more fights, there is a great possibility that Manny Pacquiao will seek the highest position of the land. There is no doubt that Manny Pacquiao is qualified to run in the highest position as well as potential to become a good president of the Philippines. He is one of the few examples of Filipinos that comes from rags to riches, and until today, he maintains his status quo in our society. A philanthropist, successful businessman, boxing icon, politician, and a family man. Sa tingin niyo ba, mga kasangkayan, may ibubugay itong ating idolo at tulad ni Pangulong Duterte, may nagbabaga ba siyang mga kamao sa pagsupo ng korupsyon sa ating bansa? Just comment below, mga kasangkayan.